Structuring your code for iOS availability is a little bit tricky. So today we are going to learn just that. I'm Alex from Rebeloper.com, and if you do want to learn how to structure your iOS 14 and iOS 15 apps in the proper way, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Let's open up Xcode and let's dive in. Now that iOS 15 is out, this is a really good time to learn about availability. So how do we use available inside our code? How do we limit and how do we actually use them on the functions of our code? So if you are new to the channel, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a one-on-one Zoom meeting, 60 minutes of debugging or learning SwiftUI with me. So with that out of the way, let's just jump right back into our Xcode project. It's Xcode 13 beta. Most probably you will also already have Xcode 13 out of beta. So what is available really mean? So we are just setting the availability of some parts of our code to a version. Now go ahead and check out the resources. There's a link in the description where you can download all the resources to my YouTube videos. Just find the date and the title of the YouTube video there, and you can download this content view. So yeah, replace that in your own project. Now, what is the difference between at available and hash available? Because if you are taking a look at the documentation, you will find both of them. Now, at available is used to mark the availability for a class or method, and hash available is used to only execute a piece of code for a specific platform and or version. We are going to take a look at an example in just a second. Now, there's the asterisk. So the asterisk is indicates availability of the declaration on all of the platform names listed above, unless specified specifically. Again, you will see this in action. So yeah, keep in mind that this is what the asterisk does. And there's the list of available attributes, iOS, macOS, and even Swift. Maybe if you want to limit your code to Swift 4.5 or 5.5 and above, you can do that also. So what I have here, let me just build and run. I do have two simulators set up, iPhone 6s, that's for iOS 14.4, and iPhone 12, that's for iOS 15. So let's run this code on iOS 15. As you can see, it's iOS 15. We have right over here is our body, a background of color red, available with a foreground color of black, and then a button with a dtab button. We will take a look at that action later on. Now, if I run the same code, let me just build this on the 6S, you will not see any difference because we, of course, we didn't have set up anything just yet. It's the same app. But what if I want to use the newly introduced cyan color inside iOS 15? And I want to default to this color.red background. So I would just go if hash available, and the platform would be iOS 15. Of course, you can just add 0.0 or whatever version you'd like. And here, there's the asterisk. And right over here, I'm just going to go color.cyan. Okay, and else I'm going to go color.red. So now let's see what happens on iPhone 6s. So if I build and run on the 6s, we should still see the red, and that indeed is what happens. If I switch to iPhone 12 and build and run there, we'll see the newly added cyan. How awesome is that? And just with a few lines of code. That's great. But what if I want to not use the if else statement? What if I want to use some guard statement? We can do that also. I'm going to do that in the get foreground color. Here we are having a black. So let's just have a guard statement here. Guard hash available iOS 15, and else, so if this isn't iOS 15, then I want to return color.black, and otherwise, if this succeeds, I want to return color.brown. So let's just go with brown Right over there. So let's build and run again. This will be on iPhone 12, so iOS 15. There's our newly added brown. This is great. Now let's see the iPhone S. It should default back to black because this isn't on iOS 15. Okay, that's really nice. Okay, so we can also add availability on to a function like this one. So let's do that. Let me just go ahead and add at available at iOS 15 and asterisk. Auto completion is failing me right over here, but no worries. So this fetch data in iOS 15 and up, this is going to be available only on iOS 15. Otherwise, the fetch data will be available pre that. So fetching data on pre iOS 15 or wherever it will be. But let's just use this in action right over here on the DTAP button. As you can see, we are just only fetching some data. Let's just have the if statement right over here. Hash available iOS 15. Okay, now we can use our fetch data in iOS 15 and up, and on the else statement we are going to use the fetch data only. So let's see if this actually works. So let us just build and run on the 6s simulator. So that's pre iOS 15. So if I just tap fetch data, we will see that right over here, fetching data in pre iOS 15, that's correct. Now, if I just run this on the iPhone 12, which is iOS 15, let's just tap on fetch, fetching data in iOS 15 and up. So this is really, really cool. Now, we can also deprecate a certain function. And let me just go a little bit down. So I just created here the fetch data deprecated. So how do we do that? Well, it's again with at available. And we want to know and which it is available. And then we just go deprecated on iOS 13, for example. And we can also add a message here. And let's add a message like, we no longer fetch data this way. Now, that's great, but how do we actually test this out? Well, we just go and call that fetch data deprecated. Well, I'm just going to copy this out and paste it in here. Now we should see a warning. And let's just wait for that. There we go. Fetch data deprecated was deprecated in iOS 13. And it says we no longer fetch data this way from iOS 13 and up. That's really nice. But what if I want to obsolete one of the functions? So I'm just going to copy this out again because we are only going to add some new stuff here. And that is obsoleted. Okay, and let's add a comma. I hope I spelled that obsoleted. Okay, obsoleted in 14, and the message, so we no longer fetch data this way from iOS and up. Now we should have in here like use let's say fetch data in iOS 15 and up instead. So use this instead. Okay, so if I will call this right over here, we will get an error. So this is obsoleted. So it says unavailable in iOS. We no longer fetch data this way in iOS 13 and up. Use fetch data in iOS 15 and up instead. So let's have these commas instead. Okay, and this, by the way, is auto-completing. It should auto-complete. There we go, instead, typed out correctly. Okay, now you might want to rename some stuff, and you already saw this in some Swift functions, and that is with at available, again, available open parentheses, and we are going to use the asterisk right over here because on all platforms, and we want to say unavailable, and then renamed, and let's just use this fetch data old name. Let's just go with fetch data. So fetch data old name was renamed to fetch data. So if we are going to call this right now, again, we will see that, okay, we don't have, has been renamed to fetch data. And if we can tap on fix it, it will just fix it for us. So let's just move back and maybe let's remove these two. Okay. Now, the next stop is, obsoleted and running iOS and lower code. Maybe you do want to kind of have a negative, so running only available on iOS 15 and lower. So let me just type this out. It's a little bit, it's a kind of negative and it's kind of an overkill in code, but currently this is the only way we can do it. So if hash available, so iOS 16, so we are going to go with 16. If this is available in 16, well, nothing is available in 16. Else, we want to print out running iOS 15 and lower. So this is how you could just kind of hack that if available syntax. Okay, finally, available in iOS 16 view. We can just set this also to views, and right over here, and let me just remove this. We can just simply go and uncomment this, and this will be fine. So if I just build and run this, you will see available in iOS 15, 16 or newer. Okay, but what if I want to limit this? So we can do that to iOS 16. So add available, there we go, iOS 16, comma and asterisk, there we go. So now you will see right over here that available is only available in iOS 16 or newer. That's really nice. Also, we can set up, and I will just finish this. Let me just copy that out. We can just have available, or rather I will just copy it. That's much, much easier if we don't have auto completion. So available iOS 16, and we can add new stuff here like Mac OS, maybe 13.0. So we can also do this. We need a comma right over there. Okay. So that is it, basically. Now you know how you can actually set this available inside your view stack. So if hash available, also you can set it for at available for functions, and then you can deprecate it or make a function or whatever obsolete it to a specific version. Now, if you did like this video, go ahead and check it out. Check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where I can teach you these kind of stuff in SwiftUI, or I can also help with bugs in your code or whatever you'd like to talk with me on a 60-minute Zoom call, one-on-one Zoom call with me at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Structuring your code for iOS versions couldn't be easier with the available property. Now that you know how to do that, go ahead and hit that like button if you did like this video. And while you're at it, make sure to hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos as I publish them on the channel. New videos like these ones, go ahead and check them out. They are really, really nice. And I talk a lot about Swift UI, Swift in general. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.